This conference will now be recorded.
Okay, so yesterday we discussed about that the basic commands mkdir, pwd, tree command, ls command, m command, right? Rm, rmdir, and touch command. 7-8 commands we discussed. So Suresh is asking one question. When I was trying the command ls-l, I got the command not found error. See, here he is doing a mistake here. He is not giving the space between the command and the option. Ls is a command. After that, whatever that option you are trying to give, you have to give the space. Okay, command, space, that option. Okay, so Suresh, you can try it. Using the space, it is going to work. Remember one thing, command, space, option you have to give, then only it is going to work. Okay, so we have created the directories, we have created the files in yesterday class. Okay, did you remember? When you are creating a directories, it is creating directories with some default permissions. So if you want to create a directories with some custom permissions, which option we used? Guys, which option we used? -m. Right, -m option we used. So if you don't use this -m option, it is going to create with some default permissions. On what basis the default permissions are going to create it? Okay, yesterday someone asked how to change that existing permissions, that Gangirid, I think he asked, or someone. So for all these things today we are going to discuss. Okay, so if you create a file, if you create a directory, right, what are the default permissions are going to set? Okay, on what basis it is going to set? How to change that default permissions to whatever we wish to give that permissions? All these things we are going to discuss. So before that, we'll discuss very important command, very important command, find command. Okay, using this find command, you can search the files, directories with various conditions. See, in your Windows machine, if you want to search a file, right, what you are going to do? Left side down, we have one option, search that input box, there you are going to search. Right, but in the Linux server, if you want to search a file or if you want to search a directory, we are going to use the find command. Using this find command, you can search the files, search the directories with various conditions. What are those conditions? Search the files which are having that 700 permissions. Find the or search the files which are created by Bhaskar user. Search all the files which are having that 1 GB size. I want to search all the files which are created 10 days back. I want to search all the files which are type Java. So like this, you can specify that various conditions when you are searching the files or directories using find command. So in one of the interview, they ask this question. I want to search all the empty files in current directory. How to search all the empty files in where? Current directory. This is the question. You have not been through in Accenture. They asked you. Okay. How to search all the empty files in current directory? We know find is a command to search files or directories. Find hyphen type F. See, using the find command, you can search the files or directories. So you have to specify. You need to search file or directory. Type F. F means files you have to search. Okay. So guys, you can stop sometime that discussion in that group chat. Later we'll discuss. Okay. Don't discuss now and don't try to practice it. When I am explaining, concentration on my class. Don't do other activities. And in between, I am going to specifically ask you, call your name, and I am going to ask. That time, if you are not going to ask, if you are not going to answer, it is very shameful for you. I am going to treat each participant as my student, irrespective of your experience or your age. When I am explaining that anything, concentration in my class, Gangi Reddy or some others, Chandra, don't discuss anything there. Okay. So find where you have to search current directory. So you have to specify that path where you want to search. Find dot, I am representing. Dot is going to represent that current directory. What you want to search? Files. What type of files? Empty files. So this command now with these options, it is going to display that all the files in current directory. All the files in current directory it is going to. Okay, but my requirement is I want all empty files. You have to add one more condition. Okay, so for this one, you can use hyphen empty. Okay, if you use that empty, this condition, it is going to display all the empty files. All the empty files in your current directory it is going to display. Clear? So like this, after this question, he asked that how to search all the empty files in root directory. Can anybody answer? Same command only. Instead of dot, you have to use it forward slash. Forward slash we are going to represent as a root directory. Okay. So if you want to search all the empty files in user home directory, how to search all the empty files in user home directory? Instead of forward slash, what you have to do? You know what is that symbol to represent that user home directory? Tilde symbol. Tilde symbol. So tilde symbol is going to represent that user home directory. Who are going to execute this command, that user home directory. Suppose if I am execute this command with the Bhaskar user, it is going to search in the this particular directory, all the empty files. Suppose if I am going to execute this command with the Balaji user, it is going to search in the Balaji home directory. Clear? Okay, so like this, I have documented with various examples, with various command, various conditions in the document. Just go ahead and practice it. Okay, clear about this find command? So I will give one more example. How to search all the empty directories? How to search all the empty directories in the current directory? Very simple. What? Instead of F, you can use that D. That's all. D represents that directory. Okay, so D represents that directory. Clear? So we'll execute this command later. So now we'll discuss about that on what basis the default permissions are going to set. Okay, so based on the umask value, it is going to set the default permissions for the directories and the files. So already we know that we have root user is there, right? And normal user. Root user is there, normal user is there in the Linux server. Yesterday we discussed it, types of users. Yes or no? So root user umask will be different, normal user umask will be different. So for root user, what is the umask value? 0022. Okay, so this is the default umask value for the root user. What is the default umask value for normal user? 0002. Okay, so these are the standard values, guys. So if I create a directory or file with the root user, what are the default permissions for file or directory? So first we'll discuss about that default directory permissions. So if I create a directory with the root user, what are the permissions it is going to set? If I create a directory with a normal user, what are the permissions I am going to set? If I create a file what are the default permissions I am going to get? If I create a file with the root user, what are the default permissions it is going to set? So it's depends on the umask value. See, base permissions for directory is 0777. This is the base permissions for the directory. That is the standard value. So from that base permissions, you have to subtract that umask value. For the umask value, for the root user, what is the umask value? 0002. You can subtract it. If I subtract this umask value, 0755. Yes or no? If you subtract that umask value from the base permissions, this is so you can use this 0755 or simply 755. So 0, the left side, it is not countable, right? So if I create a directory
with the root user, we are going to get that 755 is the permissions. We'll see what is this 7, what is 5, what is 5, what is 0, what is the 2. We'll discuss now. Okay, base permissions for file is 0666. So for directory 0777, for a file 0666. From that one you can subtract that umask value. So what is the 644? So 0644. So if I create a file with the root user, I am going to get that 644. Okay, we'll see what is this 644. Same way, if I create a file with directory with the normal user, so what is the normal user umask value? 0002. From 777, subtract that 002. It will be 775. It will be 775. Right. Same way, if you create a file, subtract the umask value. Okay. So the umask value for normal user is 0002. Subtract that umask value from the base permissions. You are going to get that 664. You are going to get that 664. Clear? Anybody have any questions so far? Whatever we discussed about that default umask value and default permissions for the directory and file, respective to that user and normal user, root user and normal user. These are very, very important. So whatever. So here we are keeping. I am going to show you in the server now. Okay. So Ibrahim, what you didn't understand? So tell me the specific topic I am going to. So these are the default umask value. Based on the umask value, the default permissions are going to set. See, yesterday we have created a directories and we have created a files. It is going to create some with the default permissions. And what basis the default permissions are going to get? Based on the umask value. And here I am showing how the umask value is going to affect the default permissions. So base value is this one, right? From the base value, you have to subtract the umask value. After subtracting whatever the value, that is the default permissions. User mask, umask means user mask. So what is the command to display that umask value? In one of the interview, they asked. Umask is a command to display the umask value. Okay, is it possible to change the default umask value? Yes, it is possible. Okay, so how to change that umask value? What is the command to change the umask value? Using the umask command only, we can display that umask value and you can set the umask value. Suppose if you want to set, can like this one. If you execute this command, okay, it is going to set the umask value. If you don't pass any permissions, just if you execute umask command, it is going to display that one. So Kranti Kumar Reddy is asking one question. Sir, why we are using the umask value 0002? 0222. Why can't we use it? Bhaiya, these are the default values operating system has set. Okay. If you want, you can change it using this umask command. You can display the umask value using the umask command. You can set the umask value using the umask only. Clear? Okay. So now we'll discuss about that. What is the 6? What is the 4? What is the 2? What is the 0? If you see, let me connect to the server first. Now you people are aware of how to connect to the server, right? So just you can type uname and you can check that whether you have connected or not. So after executing uname command, if you see the output as Linux, it is confirmed you have successfully connected to the Linux server. So now just if you type ls-l, so Bhaiya Suresh, you typed like this one, ls-l. It is saying that ls command not found. See, you should give the space between command and the option. Now see, right? So let me create a directory. How to create a directory, Suresh? Mkdir directory name devops. Right, if you see now, directory has created, file has created. Right, if you observe after executing ls-l command, it is displaying the permissions. Right, and this is a links, this is a username, this is a group name, this is the size of your file or directory, this is the timestamp when it is created or updated. So this is a file name or directory. But whatever I discussed here, I'm discussing that now the permissions in terms of numbers, but here it is displaying in the alphabets. No? Just take this one. This is a default permissions for the directory. So the directory name is DevOps. Did you remember who's created this one? Root user or normal user? Normal user. How can you say normal user? See here, ec2-user is the owner for this particular directory. So whoever created that guy, by default he will become that owner. Okay, so as a normal user we have created. Even same file also, devops.txt, we have created with the normal user devops.txt. Devops.txt. Clear? Now, how I can represent these numbers in terms of alphabets? So we have some standard values are there. Read, write, x. See here, read, write. R means read, W means write, X means execute. Okay, what is the value for R? So the standard value for R is 4. Write 2. For execute 1. Okay, read 4, write 2, execute 1. Now if you see, take this one, read, write, execute, read, write, execute, read, execute. So what is the read? 4. Write 2, 1. If you Same way, read 4, write 2, execute 1. Read 4 and execute. If you add 4 plus 2 plus 1, how much? 7. Right? 4 plus 2 plus 1, 7. 4 plus 1, 5. Right? So, if you create a directory with the normal user, you are going to get that 775 permissions. Just compare and see. If you create a directory with the normal user, what are the permissions you are going to get? 775. Yes or no? See? Clear? Same way, if you create a file with the normal user, read write 4, write 2, 4, 2, 4, 4 plus 2, 6, 4 plus 2, 6, 4. So if you create a file with the normal user, what are the permissions you are going to get? 664. Let's compare and see. Let's see. 664. Same way, if you create a file or a directory with the root user, 755 is the default permissions for the directory. 644 is the default file permissions if the file or directory is created by the root user. Clear? Now, yesterday someone was asking, what is the 700 permissions? Can you convert now that one? 700 means? If you want to get that 700, what are the things? If you want to get the 7, read, write, execute. Right? So remaining empty. 0 means no permissions at all. See, now I am going to create a directory with the 700 permissions. If you want to create a directory with the custom permissions, we are going to use that hyphen M option. Yesterday we discussed it. 700. Okay, test directory. So now if I create a directory called test with the 700 permissions, we are going to get this kind of permissions. Let's see. And just take it lsfnl. See, 700 permissions means this one. So if you observe, each file or each directory having that three sets of permissions. Take this one. So let me create one more file. Touch is a command to create the empty files. Touch basker.txt. Now if you observe, how can you say it is an empty file? See, size is 0 here. Yes or no? Okay, if you observe, this is the file basker.txt I have created. Okay. Same permissions or not? See? Okay, if you see, each file or each directory having that three sets of permissions. This is the first set, second, third. What is the first this set is going to represent? Whose permissions? This is a user, or we can call as owner of this file. So here, who is the owner of this file? EC-user. Why? Because this file has created by that EC2-user. Okay, so owner permissions are read, write. So second set is going to represent that group. Second set is going to represent group. So here, who is the group? By default, username only the group. So for group, permissions are this one. So third set is going to represent that others. So others means, if you see this particular file, username is ec-user, group name is ec-user. Okay, root is not a owner. Assume root also one user is there in this Linux server. Yes or no? Root user will become the others to this particular directory or this particular file. Why? Because he is not a owner and a root is not belongs to this particular group. So obviously he will become a others to this particular file. So other means he is not a owner and that user not belongs to that particular group. So he will become the other. So in this case, root is a other. So now for this particular file, others means root user having the read access to this particular file. Clear? So anybody have any questions on this umas value? Okay, so let me execute that umas command. See, I have logged in as a normal user. I have logged in as a normal user. If you logged in as a normal user, the umas value for normal user is 0002. Right. Sorry. Is it possible to set the umas value? Yes. Umas 0002. So guys, just you can give that simply 0002 or 0002. Both are same. Even if you don't specify the 0, you can execute it. Now we can type that umas. See? So using the umas command, you can display the umas value and you can set the umas value also. Displaying as well as setting. So if you set the umas value like this one, it is going to reflect only for this particular session. So again, if you log out and log in, again it will become the default umas value. How to change the umas value permanently? Anybody idea? Answer, you should join from laptop, don't join from mobile. Okay, so how to set the umas value permanently? Anybody idea? This is one of the interview questions. How to set the umas value permanently for the user? Okay. Value for the specific user. So for Bhaskar user, suppose our EC2 user, how to set the umas value permanently? So if you go to home directory, assume I have logged in as a EC2-user. So what is the EC2 user home directory, guys? What is the EC2 user home directory? /home/EC2-user. So if you want, you can check it, pwd. See, currently we are in the EC2 user home directory. So there, if you see, we have one file called as a .bash_profile. It is not displaying .bash_profile. .bash_, observe, file name starting with dot. Dot represents that here, if any file or any directory start with the dot, means hidden file, or we can call as hidden directory. So if you want to display the hidden files or hidden directories, what is the option we are going to use it? A option. A means all. LSFNLA. If you observe here, bash underscore profile is there. So you have to add this particular command. You mask this one into that bash underscore profile, so that it is going to be permanently set to the umask value 0222 to this particular ACT user. Suppose if you want to change the umask value permanently for all the users, how to set umask value permanently for all the users? So instead of adding this value into dot bash underscore profile, we have one file called as the profile file, which is available in the etc directory. There you have to add this one. So if you do any configurations in the profile file, which is going to reflect for all the users in that particular server. If you want to do in the user level, bash underscore profile. Each user have their own bash underscore profile in their home directory. Clear? Okay. So this is one of the intro question. Now you are clear, right? So after changing the umask value, now the umask value is 222. If I create a directory, what are the permissions I am going to get, guys? Come on. Yes, thank you, Leo. If you create Madhukar, see, the default base permissions for directory is 0777. Now that umask value is 0222. You can subtract that umask value from the base permissions. 555. Yes or no? 555 means, if you want to get that 5, read, execute. Read, execute. Read, execute. Yes or no? Not read, write, bhaiya. Let's see. Mkdir. Okay. Linux. So now Linux directory going to get that read, execute, read, execute, read, execute. Let's see. See. Read, execute, read, execute, read, execute. Clear? Now, clearly it is indicates that the default permissions are going to set based on umask value. Agree with me? Yes. Right. So now we were clear about that umask command and default permissions. So using the mkdir command -m option, while creating the directory itself, you are going to set the permissions. mkdir -m, some whatever the permissions you like it. Right. After creating, you have realized that I need to change the permissions. See, okay, for directories you have this -m option, and you can create your own permissions, whatever it you like it. But when you are creating a file, you don't have any option to set that permissions, whatever the permissions you would like it, right? Okay. After creating the file, I have realized that I need to change the permissions. Okay, so Praveen Ubai is asking that, can I know -m option means? Guys, can you help your friend? We discussed about this one. -m means mode. -p means parent. -v means verbose. These three options we discussed. Okay. So only this limit, these are the UMAS values. There is no apart from four digits. Okay. So now how to change the permissions for the file, for the directories? Yesterday one guy asked, who is that guy? How to change the permissions for the file? So for that one, we are going to use that chmod, change mode. ch means change, mod means mode. Okay, so right now for this particular file, if you observe DevOps Bhaskar.txt having that read write read, okay, means if you convert this alphabets to number 6 6 4, right, for which file? Bhaskar.txt. Now I am going to execute like this one. What will happen, guys? Chmod 000 Bhaskar.txt. If you execute like this one, like this it will be. Yes or no? Means you are removing all the permissions. Let me execute this command. Now we can type ls-l. Observe, for earlier for Bhaskar it was 664, read write 6 r4. Now no permissions at all. Okay, means we removed all the permissions for everyone, user, group, others. Now I need to give read access for everyone. How to do? Babu is saying that chmod 444 give the file name. Is it correct? I want to give read access for everyone. Is it correct? Yes, it is the correct. Read means four. For everyone, user, group, others. Everyone means user, group, others. I want to give read and execute permissions for everyone. chmod 555 Bhaskar.txt. Remember now, understand my question. I want to give all the permissions for user, read permissions for group and others. All the permissions for user, read permission for group and others. 7 4 4, correct? Yes, it is correct. 7 means all the permissions, First number is going to represent user. Second and third is going to represent group and others. For them, read. So 4 means read. Clear now? I want to give all the permissions for all, for everyone. 777. Oh, people are now full active. They cleared everything. Okay, so let me execute now. Right now, for Bhaskar.txt, we don't have any permissions. I want to give read access for everyone. chmod 444 Bhaskar.txt. Now you can check it. See, everyone got that read access. I need to give read and execute. chmod 555 Bhaskar.txt. Now you can check it. See, read and execute it. Right? So if you want to give full permissions for user 7, read 44 Bhaskar.txt. Now if you observe, for Bhaskar user full permissions, you group and others read. It is override. Earlier it was read execute for group and others. Now see, yes. Okay, so how to change the permissions for directory? Same way. See, instead of file name, we are going to mention the directory name. Now, one second, let me copy one file, Bhaskar.txt. cp Bhaskar.txt to the devops directory. I have copied Bhaskar.txt into the devops directory. Now devops directory is not an empty directory. If you go inside and see ls-li devops directory, if you observe, so inside this devops directory, Bhaskar file is there. And one more thing, if you see, if you copy the file, the inode is going to change. See, this is the inode number. After copying that Bhaskar.txt into the devops directory, see, this is inode number. But if you rename it, it is not going to change it, guys. Okay, now in the devops directory, we have one file called as Bhaskar.txt. We have two files now, Bhaskar.txt in the user home directory and inside the devops directory. Now if I execute like this one, chmod 444 devops, is it going to change the 44 permissions for devops as well as Bhaskar.txt or only the devops directory? Only the devops directory. So before that, before giving, just check the permissions ls-l devops. Okay, ls-l. See, for devops directory, read write execute read. Right, but file, read execute read. Now if I execute chmod 444 devops, you people are expecting that these 44 permissions are going to set for directory as well as file also. File it is not going to set. Just type ls-l. See, it has changed rrr. But if you go and check inside this devops directory file, okay, so it is only read, right? Yes, it is now Bhaskar.txt doesn't have the read permissions. Means in this particular directory, I have one file. So you don't have the execute access for the owner. That's why it is saying that you don't have the access to that one. Okay. So let me set the chmod 744 means for owner all the permissions and others. Now if you see ls-l, we have for owner all the permissions. Just execute ls-l devops. But still if you see, we don't have that all the permissions for owner. If you want to set that permissions for directories, subdirectories, and what are the files which is having, you have to use that -r, capital letter R, guys. So all the commands in the Linux are lower cases, and options maybe it is a uppercase or it may be a lower case. See, we used yesterday rm-r, right? So that one is a lower case. Options may be lower case or uppercase. Okay, now you can give the directory name devops. So give the permission chmod-r744. Now for this particular directory, it is going to change, and also it is going to set to that what are the permissions for subdirectories and whatever the files which are having inside this DevOps directory. Now we can check it ls-l DevOps. See, read, write, execute, read, read. So Pratap is asking, is there any command for seeing the base permissions for file or directory? No command. That is the like one standard value. Okay, so if you go and ask with your Linux Torvalds, hey, what is the base permissions you set while creating this Linux operating system, he will say that for file 666, for directory 777. That is the standard value. We don't have any command to see that one. Okay, but we proved that one. How? See, we are assuming that 666 is the base permissions, and we have subtracted the umask. We saw the umask value. We have subtracted this umask value, and we are seeing this is the file permissions. If we know this value, and we are getting this value. So if you know these two values, easily can able to understand this value, right? Sir, you are teaching math, sir. We don't want math. Just I'm saying that one. So Pratap is asking, is there any command to display this value? We don't have any command, but we can prove how we know this one. Using the umask command, we have displayed this one, and using command, we created a file. It is setting the permissions. You know this one, and you know this one. The third value is very easy. If we add these two, this value is going to get. So, can we set permissions for a directory and file using one command? So, I'm understanding your question is using the one command at a time, can we set that permissions for files and directory? It is not possible. So you can specify, see the syntax of chmod command is chmod permissions file name or directory name. There is no file name space directory name. Either one you can give it, file name or director name. So Pratyusha, she is asking, can I set the UMask value to 888? No, it is not going to take. Just if you take UMask 888, octal number out of range, maximum 77 you can give it. Yes, 77 is the limit. Okay. So using the chmod command, you set the permissions. And if you observe, so far we are using the numbers. I don't like to use the numbers. I have to use that alphabets. See, assume, let me remove that permissions for Bhaskar. Chmod 000 Bhaskar.exe. Now if you observe, no permissions for Bhaskar.txt. Right. I want to give the read access for everyone. I want to give the read access for everyone. Don't say that chmod 444. This one. I don't want to use that numbers. Instead of numbers, I want to use that alphabets. So Babu is saying that plus R. Plus means adding. R means read. Okay, let's see. Yes, this is the correct one. So you can use chmod plus R to give that read access for everyone. So we are going to get this type of permissions. Now once we execute this command, you are going to see this one. Let's see. Yes, see RRR. Right. So if you want to remove, minus. If you want to add, plus. Now my requirement is, for user I want to give all the, okay, so I want to give the write access also. I want to give the write access for everyone. Sorry, W1. Huh? I want to give that execute access plus X. So let's execute this one. And one more thing, if you see now, the Bhaskar.txt having that read. Right. Now if I execute this one, what will happen? R will be remain same, or it is going to override with www. So after executing this command, the result will be like this, R so first option or second option. This is the first one, or second option. After executing this command, right now these are the permissions. Right now these are the permissions. Now I am executing this one. So first option we are going to get, our second option first only. Yes. So if you use that alphabets, it is not going to override. But if you use the numbers, it is going to override whatever you are giving currently. Now if you observe, you are expecting that everyone is going to get the write access. Yes or no? But it's not like, let's see. See, only that. So for no one, it has given. For no one, it has given that write access. Why? So You have to specify. By default, read it is going to give to everyone. But write it is not going to give. You have to specify G U G O. U means user, G means group, O means others. You have to specify. For R, even if you don't specify, it is going to work. U G O R just plus R, it is going to work. Plus R R U G O, it is going to work. Now if you observe LSFNL, see, read, write, read, write. Let's see, CHMOD plus X basket.txt. See that LSFNL. If you observe, it is giving that. But write, it is not going to give. As a security constraint, they are not giving. Now I will ask one question with you guys. So guys, same using these alphabets, you can set that permissions for directories also. So if you want to set the permissions for directories and subdirectories, you should use that -R. Okay. Now I will ask one question. This is one of the entry question. I have a one file called as devops.txt, which is having that these type of permissions. Now, as a user, assume this file is created by that EC2-user. Now, EC2 user can able to update the content which is already existed. Assume in this devops.txt having that hello guys. So instead of hello, is it possible to change to hi guys? Is it possible? So three people said that no. Why? Can you give me that? See, we have the W access. W means write. Right, then he can able to write. See, Godhan is saying that yes. Godhan is good boy. That's why he's saying that yes. See, W means write. Easily we can able to write, right? It is not possible, Godhan. Why? Because you don't have the read access. Without read, how we will see that existing content? Without having the read access, how we will see that first of all content? Without seeing, how we will update it? So this is like a little tricky, right? So that's why interviewers are asking the questions. Yes or no? So everyone will assume yes, he have the write access, he can able to update it. But without R, WX is waste. You are not able to see the content. Without seeing the content, how we will update it? Clear? Okay. So anybody have any questions so far? So we'll discuss about that find command now. We'll execute it. We'll discuss. We'll execute the find command. See, currently, if you see, basket.txt is an empty file. Linux is an empty directory. Test is an empty directory. So let me display that first file find in my current directory. So currently I'm in this directory. Dot represent current directory. -hyphen type. Okay. F. So F means file. -hyphen empty. So what is the output you are expecting now? Two files. Basket.txt and another basket.txt which is available in the DevOps directory. See here, in DevOps directory, basket.txt is there. So outside another in the current directory also it is there. Right? So if you want to see the empty directories, D. See, test directory, Linux directory, and in this particular directory, config directory, PRO CPS, CPS1 directory is there. So like this, you can search the files or directories with the help of the find command, and you can specify the conditions. Clear? Anybody have any questions so far? Whatever we discussed, so we discussed it today, find command, umask command, and chmod, only three commands so far, right? More than 1 hour it took for discussing about these three commands, but how much information we got it? Yes sir, no? So for changing the permissions, we can use that chmod. Now I want to change the ownership. If you see, for this particular file basket.txt, who is the owner? EC2-user. Assume EC2-user is leaving this project. So whatever he is owning that files, he want to transfer ownership. He want to transfer the ownership. Okay. How to transfer that ownership from one user to another user? Now, owner of this basket.txt is a EC2-user. I want to change the ownership to that root user, because currently in this Linux server, only two users are there. One is a root user, another one is EC2-user. So whatever the ownership you are going to change, that user should exist currently. See, take one example. You have a one bike, okay? Leo Thomas having one bike. He want to sell that bike. He want to sell, means that other person has to exist. Here also, you want to transfer your ownership. To whom you need to transfer, that user has to exist in this your Linux server. So root is another user. Okay, and one more thing, Leo Thomas is the owner of his bike. He's going to sell to that Suresh. Suresh is available, but can he be able to transfer his ownership to Suresh? Even though Leo Thomas is the owner of that particular bike, he sold that bike to the Suresh, but still he don't have authority to transfer his ownership. To whom we need to contact? RTO guy. Yes or no? Here also, even EC2-user is the owner of that particular file basket.txt, but he don't have authority to transfer that ownership to that other user. Who is going to do in this case now? Root user. As a normal user, you are not able to transfer your ownership to that other user. So if you want to transfer that ownership, if you want to change the ownership, chown, ch means change, ow means owner. Change owner. Okay, chown, new owner name, root. This is the username which is already existed in our Linux server. Which file? Basket.txt. Now, as a normal user, if you try to access it, let's see what error we are going to see. Changing ownership of basket.txt operation not permitted. So switch to the root user. Sudo su. See, now I have switched. Right now I am the root user. And if you see that right now for basket.txt EC2-user, now you can execute chown root basket.txt. If you observe, see, username, the user has changed. Earlier it was EC2-user, now it has root. Same way you can change the ownership to that directory also. How? chown root devops. If I change the ownership like this one, will it is going to change the ownership to subdirectories or files which are having DevOps directory? No. If you want to change the ownership to subdirectories for the files which are having inside the directory, what you have to do? Hyphen R, capital letter R, CHOWN, capital letter R, recursively, R means recursive. Now you can check it, LS-L, DevOps. So DevOps having that Bhaskar directory, Bhaskar file, see? Even for DevOps directory also changed, see? So using the CHOWN command, we have changed the ownership. Same way, see, this is the group name. Is it possible to change the group name? Yes, how? CHGRP, CHGRP, change group. CH means change, GRP means group. So group name we have to pass. By default, one group is there, inbuilt group name, wheel. So later we'll create a username, group name, whatever we like it. So right now we'll go with that existing username and group. CHGRP, group name, and for which file? Bhaskar.txt. So now copy and execute it. Okay. Oh, WHEL. See, if you give wrong group name, okay, it is going to say that invalid group. WHEL. See, now if you check it, LS-L for Bhaskar, user and group both has changed. So Sunil is asking, can we change ownership for multiple directories using one command? So you mean Suresh, you mean Sunil, DevOps, Linux, test at a time? It is not possible. But inside this DevOps directory, whatever the subdirectories, it is possible. It is not possible, DevOps, Linux, test at a time. Let's try it. CHOWN. Okay, then root DevOps Linux test, specify the directory name. Oh, it is possible. See, yes, it is possible. Just specify that, separated by space, that directory names. Okay, see here, wheel is a group, it is a group name. It is a group name, the inbuilt group, which is going to come along with your operating system. We didn't create this group. Okay. Now, is there any way with a single command can change the owner name and group name at a time? Right now, we are using the CHOWN for changing the owner. For changing the group, CHGRP. Is there any single command to change that username, means that username and group name at a time? Yes, CHOWN, CHOWN, username. So I'm going to revert back EC2-user, group name, I'm using that EC2-user. So this is a group name for which file? Bhaskar.txt. So right now for Bhaskar.txt, if you observe, root is the username, wheel is the group name. Now I'm changing username and group name also using the CHOWN. So colon you have to give. Now if you observe, LS-L, see, username, group name has changed. Okay, clear? So you can revert back. CHOWN EC2 iPhone user, okay, DevOps, Linux, test. Now if you observe, it is reverted. Yes, if you have any questions, you can ask with me in that group chat. Madhu, go ahead and ask. So guys, clear so far whatever we discussed? CHOW and CHGRP. Okay, so next question, next commands, CP command, MV command, right? WC, while command, LN command. So we are going to continue in the next class. So Madhukar is asking one question. Using CHOWN, root DevOps, the name changed without using R. Name change, we didn't change it any name. See Madhukar, we didn't change it that name. We are using that -R option. If you use that -R option inside this particular directory, whatever the files are there, whatever the subdirectories are there, for those directories and files also going to change the ownership. Same, we used the -R option for CHMOD also. Yes, to change the ownership also, we can use that CHOWN-R, that new owner name, mention the directory name. Okay, so recursive, if you want to change, you should use that -R. So you can use that -R option along with the CHMOD command, CHOWN command, CHGRP command for the directories. For the files, no need. Clear? Anybody have any questions so far? Whatever we discussed, that commands. So these are the commands in this slide we discussed today. And see here, I have documented. So CHOWN, CHGRP, these are the commands you should execute as a root user only. And one more thing, people are going to do many times this mistake. Okay, right now if you see, for Bhaskar.txt, owner is ec-user. So they are trying to do like this one, CHOWN, CHOWN, Bhaskar, and Bhaskar.txt. See, whatever the username you are passing, that user has to be exist in your server first. You are going to get error, invalid user. So right now only two users are there. Bask, this root user, and ec-user. Clear? Anybody have any questions? No questions? Thank you. We'll see you tomorrow.